Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Best of PowerPoint, and in this video you will learn a very amazing intro animation effect in PowerPoint 2016. Before beginning with the tutorial, I want to tell you guys that you can download this reference PPT file so that you can have a clear idea of this animation effect. I'll be giving the download link of this PPT file in the YouTube show notes below. And guys, this animation effect has been inspired from the video logo of the channel named Captured It. So without wasting any time, let's quickly start with the tutorial. Insert any desired image in your slide. Insert a rectangle shape in your slide and change its color to red. Then insert a word art in your slide and enter the text on which you want to apply the effect. Please do take care that you need to enter the word art style only and not the simple text box, since this animation effect will only work with the word art style. Apply any desired font to the text. I am applying the bold font, and the download link for the same has been given in the description box below. If you don't know how to download and install any new font in PowerPoint, then I have already uploaded a separate video regarding this, and you can find the link for the same in the video description. Now select the shape, and then holding the shift key, select the text box. Go to the format tab, hit the merge shapes button and select subtract. Then zoom out a little bit and increase the size of the shape such that the text should cover a large area of the slide. Then closely observe my actions on the screen. I will insert another rectangle shape in the slide at the left of the previous shape, and I will group the two shapes so that I can get more room in the starting of the text. Alright, now arrange the first alphabet at the right of the slide. Go to the animation tab and apply left motion path to the shape. Increase the length of the motion path. Open the effect options and reduce the smooth start and smooth end buttons to 0 seconds. Under the timings tab, select start with previous and set the duration of animation to 5 seconds and click OK. Let's have a look what we have achieved so far. Amazing! So we are done with the first part of this effect. Now insert a new slide and again insert the same image. Follow the same process. Insert the rectangle shape and remove the text from the shape. Now here comes the very crucial part of this effect. Count the number of alphabets of your heading text and make as many number of duplicate copies of it. In my case, I'll be making 16 copies of this shape and give each copy a separate color as random as possible. You can use the shortcut keys Ctrl plus C for copy and Ctrl plus V for paste. Please take care that all the shapes must be completely overlapping with each other. Then follow these steps for each of the shape. Insert another rectangle shape and cover the rest of the alphabets except the first one. Change its color and remove its outline so that it completely merges with the other shape. Group both the shapes and add disappear animation effect to it. Right click the grouped shape and select send to back. Now repeat the same steps, except that this time leave the first two alphabets uncovered. Mm-hmm. Similarly, leave the first three alphabets uncovered for the third shape and so on. Now you need to be very patient at this time since this process will take 10 to 15 minutes. When you reach the last alphabet, select the shape and add grow or shrink animation effect to it. Open the effect options and change the size to huge, that is full 100%. Under the timing tab, select start after previous and set the duration of animation to 2 seconds. Now since the image is going a little bit upwards as it expands, let's add a downward motion path to it to rectify this. Open the effect options and apply the same settings as mine. Then finally, add a fade exit effect to it and apply the same effect settings as mine. Then holding the shift key, select all the disappear exit effects of the shapes and select start after previous and set the duration to 0.2 seconds. Let's see what we have achieved so far. Perfect. There is only one thing left out, that this animation experiences a sudden jerk as the slide changes. So what I will do is, I will club both the slides together. Please closely follow my actions on the screen. What I am doing is, just I am making the elements of the first slide disappear and the elements of the second slide appear at the end of the animation of the first slide so that it does not experience that jerk during the slide transition. This animation effect is obviously for intermediate and advanced PowerPoint users, but I have tried to explain it to my best so that even beginners are able to create this animation effect. So that's it guys, I hope that this video was helpful to you. Please like and share the video and please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you in my next video.